What if I told you that there's a new kind of computer that could one day change our world? One that could possibly help us discover new planets, improve artificial intelligence, power the world with completely renewable energy, and even cure diseases. Just to name a few. Well, people, it's in the works. And it's called quantum computing. And to see what this futuristic, superpowered machine is all about, I went to the IBM Research Center Think Lab in New York to meet up with Talia Gershon, a material scientist in charge of the future of computing, quantum computers.
Yeah, I always loved the sciences, but I remember one time in my AP physics class, my physics teacher set up an experiment where he had a cannon and he was going to hit a troll that was a certain distance away. And we had to calculate the angle of the cannon. And I just thought that was so cool. It was like, we can master our understanding of the physical world enough that we could figure this out. And from then I was like, yes, how far can we push this?
And to find out just how far she has pushed it, Talia is going to show me the coolest computer in the world.
Hey, Erica! Great to meet you. Welcome. So cool. This is a replica of what it looks like inside a quantum computer.
Gotcha.
Looks like I could stand underneath it and get transported back to the 1800s. I mean, what does this computer do that my regular computer can't do?
There's certain kinds of problems that your regular computer just can't solve. Some examples are simulating chemistry, finding the best possible solution among many possible solutions. So we think that over time, these kinds of quantum computers will enable us to learn a lot more about a lot of things, like disease and materials and chemistry and all kinds of things.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Quantum computers process information differently. They mimic nature, and that's because they make use of the properties of quantum mechanics. You know, all those tiny particles like electrons and protons that make up the universe.
I'm gonna be honest, I don't even really know how a regular computer works. Maybe we start at the beginning. What's the difference?
So when you interact with your computer, right, you are trying to communicate some kind of information to your computer. Every letter you type, every button you click in your browser, all of that at the end of the day is being processed by your computer as zeros and ones. Okay, so how are quantum computers different, right? So what's different about a quantum computer is that instead of just having information being either a zero or a one, you can be in superpositions of zero and one.
What is a superposition?
A combination of two states. It'd be like a combination of zero and one at the same time. Let's use an analogy.
Okay.
So I've got this penny that we're gonna use for our analogy. Penny
That's
can
a
be
a big penny.
So if I take my penny and I put it on the table,
sure.
And I ask you, is my penny heads or tails? Is it zero or one?
It's heads, and it's our lucky day because we found penny.
That's right. It's gonna either be heads or tails. It's gonna either be zero or one. Right, so these are the options that your classical computer has. Mm-hmm. So what's different about quantum computing? You can actually effectively spin your penny. Okay, so wanna give it a try? You wanna spin your penny? Okay, so while it's spinning, if I ask you, is the penny a zero or a one?
Both.
It's both, right? It's in a combination of both.
So in a normal computer, each bit can only be a one or a zero. In a quantum computer, each qubit can be both a 1 and a 0. So two qubits could be 00, 01, 10, or 11. So the more pennies, or qubits, the quantum computer has, the exponentially more powerful it becomes.
Quantum information is very fragile, right? So if we heat it up or we have any kind of light or heat touch the quantum processor, it's gonna destroy the quantum information.
How cold are we talking?
About 100 times colder than outer space.
Okay, so that pretty much ruled out me getting a quantum laptop. But what I learned today did blow my mind. This is the future of computers, people. So cool.